In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create paper without using any footage. Why? Because it gives you full control over your layout and your style. And I'll show you how to add ink text. For the paper, let's add a shape layer by double-clicking on the rectangle tool. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. Let's use a gradient fill with two off-white colors. Very subtle, but nevertheless different to a solid fill. We need to adjust the start and end of the gradient, moving the two blue handles. Then let's add a paper texture. Therefore, we use the turbulent noise effect. We add it, and let's name the layer, of course, paper. In the first step, let's add some basic structure. Increase the contrast to 75, brightness to 60. That leaves just a few gray spots. In transform, we scale it down to around 10. Let's increase the complexity to 10 for more detail. Let's zoom in. You can see the random dots. We set the blending mode of the effect to multiply because we want the gradient fill to shine through. Let's name this effect structure or noise or whatever. We duplicate the effect, rename it stains, because now we add some stains to the paper to make it look less clean. Let's set the fractal type to rocky, noise type linear, contrast 800, brightness 10. In transform, let's scale it up to 500. Let's reduce the complexity to 5. And this time we set the blending mode to add. This generates orange, red stains. The color depends on your gradient fill colors, of course. To make it a convincing texture, we need to add some folds. Therefore, we duplicate the top effect because the settings are closer to what we need. And move it down. Let's name it folds. We set the noise type to block. Contrast to around 50, brightness around 45. In transform, we set scale to around 1800. Complexity 1. Then we offset the turbulence until we find a detail we like. You could rotate the texture as well, of course. You should play around with all the settings anyway and adjust them to what you think looks good. Alright, these fold lines look way too perfect though. Let's mess them up a tiny little bit. To do that, we use turbulent displays. Let's reduce the amount to 4, size around 80, complexity 10. You can set the quality to high if you want. The folds look much more convincing now. Finally, let's add some noise. Amount 5%, no color noise. To save this as a preset, select all effects, go to animation, and save animation preset. Name it, of course. You can now quickly throw it on any solid. I think we should add some lines to the plain paper. With no layer selected, we choose the pen tool and draw a horizontal line. Hold shift to make sure it is straight. No fill, of course. Let's set the stroke width to 3 pixels and choose a stroke color, like cyan or whatever you want. Let's name the layer lines. Then we add a repeater. Open the group. And in transform, we set the X position value to 0 and increase the Y value instead. We need more copies. And let's increase the distance between the lines. I think we should darken the color a little bit. Finally, we copy the turbulent displace effect from our paper texture and paste it to the lines layer. Maybe reduce the amount to 2. Besides having convincing textures, there is one more thing. Creating smooth and organic animations is one of the most important skills to have as a motion designer. Learn to use the tools After Effects provides to adjust the time and the path your shapes take. Learn different techniques and principles to give your objects the illusion of gravity, weight, mass, and flexibility. For this mini course, I went through my 20 years of experience to filter out the most valuable tips, tricks, and techniques for you. Knowledge that instantly improves your work. Smooth Animator is your kickstart into smooth and organic animations. Make sure to check out the link. Now, let's add some ink text. I've already added text. The font I use is called Satisfy. Available on Adobe Fonts. Fill color, a dark blue. You can use any font, of course. I think some kind of handwriting makes sense. Then we add a new solid. We create a luma mat for the text layer and add turbulent noise again. Use the effects and presets window to search for it and drop it onto the solid. Contrast around 600, brightness 45. In transform, we set scale to around 5 and complexity to 10. We use the solid as luma track mat for the text layer, the sun icon. We basically ripped a lot of small holes into the text. Then let's duplicate the text layer, unlink the track mat and duplicate the mat layer. Use it as luma track mat. In the turbulent noise effect of the new mat layer, we increase the scale to around 30 and reduce the complexity to 1. Looks like this. We link the second text layer to this matte layer. Why? We add Gaussian blur to this text layer. Don't repeat edge pixels, increase the blurriness. And you can see parts of the text that the luma matte reveals getting blurry. To add some texture to the blurred parts, we add roughened edges and set the border to around 2. Complexity 10. The edges are much more random now. These settings depend on the size of your text. Let's take a quick look on how to animate a text like that. There are 4 layers. Let's pre-compose them first of all. We select the layers, right-click on them, and choose Pre-compose. Let's name it Pre-text. Then, with no layer selected, we use the pen tool to redraw the letters. Increase the stroke width so that everything is covered. We set the line caps and line joints to round. Then animate the strokes with trim path animators. We use the shape layer as alpha track mat for the pre-comp. And by animating the paths, we reveal the text. Check out the project file, the link is in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.